Hello everyone, I am Dr. John Alapart and I'm a surgical oncologist, marrow faculty for subspecialty. It gives me great pleasure to invite Dr. Shreyasi P, who has secured a AIMS merit list rank of 3 and a common merit list rank of 3 in the recently concluded INI-SS. So a big congratulations to Dr. Shreyasi P.
Thank you so much, sir.
So, Tracy, in this our agenda in this interview is just basically two things. One is to get a little to know about your strategy and how marrow helped in your strategy. So, before that, I would just like to know a little bit about yourselves. Where you did your UG, your PG, which year you finished your PG, and when did you write your INI-SS? Is this your first, second attempt as well?
Awesome. Yes, sir. I'm Dr. Shreyasi. I'm from Karnataka, Chikmagalur. I did my MBBS from Shimoga Institute of Medical Sciences in Karnataka. And I did my MS General Surgery from PGMR, Chandigarh. I finished my MS in December 2023 and I had joined as a senior resident in PG itself. Following that, I started preparing for MCS from January of this year. This was my second attempt. I had given in April also. NEET, I was preparing for NEET initially, but NEET ka result was not that good. So it affected my INI-SS also. For INI-SS, I had prepared from marrow completely. I had saw all of your videos and Thomas sir's videos also. They were very informative. But one mistake which I did was I didn't solve much of MCQs during that time. And NEET ka result also came before INI-SS exam itself. So that also took away kind of my confidence during INI-SS. So I got qualified, but I got a rank of 33. So then I started again preparing again for this session. So Sabistran ka new edition got released during that time also. So it was like we have to get new information that time. So many questions may come from that. Karke. I had started studying Sabistran during the month of September and October. Till the end of October end, I studied Sabistran for some 70% of it I was able to complete. Following that November, I completely focused on INI-SS in the month of November. I had already saw all the videos of marrow. So I had marrow notes also for SS. So I studied all the notes. I revised again and again. And I knew what my mistake was in the last session. So I solved as many questions as possible. I revised again and again. And I think that helped in my theory. Compared to last session, INI-SS questions were little bit easier compared to last sessions. And general surgery questions, 30 questions were there. They were a bit easier. We were able to solve it. So I was a bit tense thinking that the question paper is easy. So many people would have qualified and would have done better also. Good. So that was the thing. And 230 people qualified during first round. So that was a bit shocker also. So I was not hoping that it may turn out to be a good thing for me. Then after interview was it was easier. They take for some 10 minutes. Not much will be asked in the interview. About statistics and some 2-3 questions related to surgical oncology were asked. I was able to answer all of them. And then I secured a rank of 3. And
so from 33 to 3.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So basically what I've been conducting a few interviews like this for the past 2 years, but the key word which I kind of get from all these interviews is revision.
Yes, sir.
Revision, revision, revision. So even in, I think even in life, revision is very important. So,
yes, sir.
So anywhere, any exam, everybody's key word is revising and revisiting the same topic again. So that is one word which I always get from all the toppers who have got good ranks.
Yes, sir. Second, sticking to my notes, reading again and again.
Second very key point which anybody who's listening to the video should take away is the point of grand tests or MCQs. Because 80 questions, how many hours was it, the exam?
90 minutes.
90 minutes. So 1 hour, 30 minutes. Sitting for 90 minutes, training your mind to sit for 90 minutes is the first thing. And then attempting 80 questions is the other thing. So to sit there and train your mind to answer 80 questions of MCQs. So doing MCQs, if you read everything page to page, if you read, see all your videos second by second, even despite all that, if 80 questions of MCQs are given, the person who has done more MCQs will fare better. Is that, I think that is the take home message which you would like to give.
Yes, sir. We'll understand what they're wanting from that questions. Otherwise, we'll all be knowing the theory, but MCQ solving question, like, strategy is needed.
Exactly. Exactly. So two things, revision and solving MCQs. That is what one thing which Shreyasi wanted to focus on. And I would just like to ask you, why surgical oncology? Just people who are MS people who are still undecided, I would ask you why surgical, and especially since PGI Chandigarh does not have a surgical oncology department.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The same questions were asked for me in the interview also. Why surgical oncology? And there is not, why there is no department in your
department in PGI Chandigarh? Yeah, yes, that's an often asked question. Yeah.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We don't have a consultant over here, sir, in surgical oncology department. So to initiate,
probably you should answer why surgical oncology first.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Surgical oncology, because it's a vast branch, and I think I'll get to do so many things. Like, there will be excitement daily. I'm not doing the same thing again and again. There will be excitement. One day, if I'm interested, I'll like 1 week, I can think about breast surgeries. Then I can be thinking about thyroid surgeries. And or some week, if I'm excited, then I'll be thinking about Whipple's and HPV surgeries or head and neck surgeries. So it's a vast branch. So it will keep me excited.
I just would like to add, see, yes, now I'm doing what you said. So I was just telling Sakshi, who got 8th rank, the same thing. Yes. She was also telling it's a vast field. So that is, yes, that can be a boon as well as a bane.
Yes, sir,
so
yes,
at present, yes, I am doing something like what you're saying. So last week I operated tibial chondrosarcoma limb salvage, proximal tibial chondrosarcoma. This week I'm operating breast or rectum. So last week is gynec and bone tumors. This week is again breast and GI. Oh, so there is a lot of diversity. But at the same time, down the lane, you might have to subspecialize, stick. Maybe for 3-4 years, you can dabble in all your general surgical oncology.
Yes, sir.
And depending on your area of interest, you have to finally subspecialize.
Yes, sir.
So your area of interest is breast oncology?
HPV, sir.
HPV. Okay, a lot of people are going GI.
I'd like to see, explore and see, sir, in the future.
Okay, that's fair enough. Fair enough. So yes, if you had, I just want to know how you went about strategizing and using the Marrow videos. So you told me that you took, you saw all the videos, and yes, how long did it take for you to see all the videos? How much time did you take? And once you wrote notes, did you go back and see the videos at double speed, or
yes, sir,
did you use any strategy? I just want to know.
Last time for last INI, I had seen all the videos in 1.5x time speed. At that time, I had seen completely, like, giving proper time for that. It took me some 1 month to complete all the videos, all the oncology videos. This time I didn't see completely those, in between that time when I was studying, and I felt like this I'm not able to retain by myself. I used to see the video, same video, in 2x speeds, mostly uro oncology and gynec oncology. That we won't be seeing the cases, those cases.
You won't be familiar with it.
Yes, sir, we are not familiar with those things. So I used to see those videos again and again, every day almost, some two in the night time when I was studying. If I'm not feeling like studying at that time, I used to watch videos. Those were in 2x speed also. My auditory memory is good than reading for me. So that worked for me. I used to watch videos in 2x speed during second time revision. And for one day before exam, I just took out my Marrow notes and I just turned all the pages. It was not like I was actively revising or something. I was just turning the pages so that I'm familiar with what is written over there, and I will be able to recall it during the exams. And I made some sticky notes and all, which I used to see daily almost. So those things.
Daily MCQ, a quota of MCQs, yes, daily?
Yes, sir. I had made it a point that in the month of November, daily During in the early morning, we INI-SS is conducted in early morning. So during that time, for 1 hour, I used to like solve MCQs. Like I wanted to train my brain so that during that time every day it will be on its best. So it will help me out. It is like simulation I used to do, sir.
Yeah.
So daily I used to solve MCQs, sir.
This is something what I heard similarly from all toppers. The same time you are sitting when the exam is going to happen, 1 month before, you are sitting there and writing 80 questions, 1.5 hours every single day. So that trains your mind to be at the best at that point of time when the exam is going to happen.
Yes.
That is a very good point which you have raised, Shreyasi. So another thing I would like to ask you is, interview when it happened,
yes, sir.
How you said it was a 10-minute interview.
Yes, sir.
And in this 10-minute interview, how was the questions asked? First question is obviously always, why did you take surgical oncology? And for your case, PJ Chandigarh, why you didn't have a department in PJ Chandigarh? That is generic. Then what were the questions asked?
One question from statistics, sir. I was asked about forest plot to explain about it and odds ratio. And
I just want to ask, just out of my curiosity,
yes, sir.
Were you there for one small webinar which I conducted in for some INI-SS qualified people? No, you didn't.
Yes,
because these actually, these are the questions which I told will be asked, like forest plot, then hazard ratio. So certain things which are the usual questions which are asked. It was just I was just happy to hear, because last candidate also, Dr. Sakshi, also was telling me she was asked about BRCA1 and BRCA2 and genetics and etiology of breast cancer, which was something which I had told this will be asked, and happy to hear that it happens to be that questions. That's all. But in maybe next time it might not be asked. But usually I think AIMS is kind of predictable. You can predict, like there are 30 questions of general surgery, hardcore 50 questions of surgical oncology, correct?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And most of those questions, like last candidate also was telling, who Sakshi, who got 8th rank, she was telling me some of them are staging based questions, some of them are scenario based questions, and some of them are post-op complications.
Yes, sir.
So, you, for the benefit of the people listening, I think if you base your preparation on that, you can actually, each sub-site, you can really divide and do it.
Yes,
NEET is more unpredictable.
Yes, sir. They can ask from anything in NEET, but INI is very structured, sir.
Very and structured.
Last time, they had asked more about trials and all, even last session also. But this session, there were no trials asked.
No trials were asked. But trials may be asked. If you can tell.
Yes, trials may be asked.
What were the trials which were asked? Just the names. And secondly, in this interview, what was asked to you?
Yes, sir. In this interview, I was asked about forest plot and rectal cancer. One will be from the system, mostly rectum cancer or breast cancer related questions or gastric cancer.
What was asked in rectum?
Rectum cancer, how will you manage metastatic cancer to the liver, like colorectal liver mets?
Okay,
sir. Yes, sir. And last time they had asked me about stomach cancer, presenting an obstruction, if you are operating in emergency, what you will do, that kind of questions relating to that. And one question was from breast cancer, sir, and SLNB.
Yes.
SLNB, okay. Breast cancer and
lung. Those are areas which are high-yield areas. You had prepared for those areas.
Yes, sir. Those, for theory, we had read also. So that was helpful, sir. And
breast, metastatic colorectal mets in liver, colorectal mets, liver mets, how to manage. Then one more you said.
Stomach cancer related. Okay. Yes, CNA stomach, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
And and one question from general onco surgery, sir, related to palliative care. The questions in the interview were a bit easier only, sir. Like they were asking, what do you mean by palliative and how do you manage palliation? What is sentinel role?
Most of these questions, if you look at the chapters of DIVITA,
yes, sir.
It is based on that, but you cannot read page by page. So probably certain you will have an idea of what is going to be asked, and probably you have to associate with somebody who is a surgical oncologist of some years of practice, so he can give you the, and who's a little bit updated also, who can tell you these things.
Yes, sir. And it is covered in general onco surgery part also, sir, in marrow. So that was helpful. Radiation and all. Yes, sir.
Correct. Radiation, did they ask you any question in interview? No.
Not specifically this time.
But only a 10-minute interview. It was structured 10-minute interview. One system, maybe one or two system questions and one biostatistical question. This is general. This is general.
Yes, sir.
Anything, what is your message you would like to give all the surgical oncology aspirants who might be listening to this?
Yes, sir. According to me, general surgery, whatever they are studying, that is enough. But for surgical oncology, marrow videos and notes are enough with MCQs. If they see the videos again and again and study, revise the marrow notes properly, if they have made any notes, that and along with solving MCQs, that much is really enough, sir. The paper, almost every 80 questions, I know it is all from notes itself, but some questions I might have made some silly mistakes, because of that I have reduced little marks, but most of the questions, everything is there in the notes. So stick to the notes and revise again, rather than going behind collecting so much information, revising again and again, that much is enough, and solving MCQs.
Very important thing to understand, trying to read textbook page to page, trying to get, if a new edition comes out, go. That is also a little difficult when some people say a new edition comes out, you have that feeling, oh, am I going to miss? But that one question, which might come out of the new edition, you are losing so many hours to go behind that. So it's important that you make a plan, stick to a plan. And only if you feel your plan is really not working, you should change that plan. Or else stick to it, revise. And were you working during this time?
No, sir, I was not working.
You were not working. You were
full-time. I was working as a medical officer, but that is not that hectic, sir. I was able to give time for myself.
Perfect. So, congratulations once again, Shreyasi P, for a very commendable achievement, I would say. And welcome to the fraternity of surgical oncology. Hope to see you in one of those our national conferences, NATCON, the conferences. And please come and say hi when we see each other. Yes. Okay.
I had imagined this moment so many times, sir, that me giving interview with you, sir.
But it is. I would like to believe that it is only like 10 to 5% of whatever the contribution of mine is. It is 95% the effort which you guys take, because it's not easy to get a rank. It's never easy, and it's very difficult to be dedicated hard work as you finish your post graduation again to study. So it's a great achievement. To all the viewers listening, revise and do your MCQs and don't give up and continue studying. If surgical oncology is your passion, you will reach there, and it's a great subspecialty to work in. Yes. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir.